Hello students, today we will start the chapter terpenoids. So what is terpenoid? It is a class of compound that give plants their color, odor, flavor, etc. It occurs in leaves and fruits of higher plant. Now comes the isoprene rule. The molecules of all terpenes are constructed of two or more isoprene units. Isoprene is actually iso C5 units, which are joined in head to tail fashion. So this is the structure of isoprene, 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Just we can see the structure and the skeleton structure where we have denoted the head and tail form. This part is head and this part is tail. Next, if we take the example of one alkaloid myrcene, we can see that it is consist of the head part and the tail part. We can denote the head part, this part, and this is the tail part. This is the skeleton structure which we will often used in case of alkaloid synthesis, depictions and its structure. Okay. Now we classify terpenoids as monoterpenes, where consist of C10, 2 isoprene unit, sesquiterpene, C15, 3 isoprene unit, diterpenes, C20, 4 isoprene unit, triterpenes, C30, 6 isoprene unit, tetraterpenes, C40 and 8 isoprene unit. So, upon the structure of carbon atom, we can see the isoprene unit are so divided. Among that, we can another see that acyclic, monocyclic, bicyclic and tricyclic consist of number of rings associated with it. We will however talk with acyclic, that is no ring, and one monocyclic, only one ring. And the chapter which we are going to help today is only monoterpenoids. Now acyclic monoterpenes, we can see osimine, which is from having a essential oil basil oil, myrcene found in the essential oil bearberry oil. Acyclic oxygenated monoterpenes, for example geraniol or citral. Geraniol is found in rose oil and citral is in lemon oil. These are all essential oil which can be taken out from the plant extract and consist of terpenoids. Now this is monocyclic monoterpenes. So monocyclic monoterpenes consist of limonene, menthol. Menthol is found in mint oil and limonene is found in lemon and orange oil. Bicyclic monoterpenes are alpha pinene, where it can be found in turpentine oil, and camphor, which is found in camphor oil. Moving to the next plot, we can see the general properties of terpenoids. It is colorless, having a fragrant liquid. Sometimes some of the terpenoids are also solid. Lighter than water, volatile in steam, soluble in organic solvent, optically active, and possesses antiseptic properties. So the first part which we will start today is citral. Citral is having a molecular formula of C10H16O. It is having lemon-like odor. It is an acyclic monoterpenoid, having the skeleton structure this one, and can be found out in grass oil and any oil of citrus fruit. It occurs as geometrical isomerism. The cis part is this and the trans part is that. Cis part is called citral A and trans part is called citral B. The presence of two carbon-carbon bond. Citral having the molecular formula C10H16O, when added with two molecular of bromine, will give tetrabromide. The presence of CHO bond can be depicted. Citral upon oxidation with silver oxide gives uronic acid. That is, this aldehyde group is oxidized into acidic group. Again, if this part aldehyde group is reduced with sodium amalgam, we get geraniol, that is alcoholic group. Thus, the presence of aldehyde group is shown by these two reactions. Next, indication of carbon-carbon double position, carbon-carbon bond position. If we take citral, and here we will talk about cis1. Citral, upon using KMnO4 and chromic oxide, we can see it gives rise to acetone, levulinic acid and oxalic acid. That is, if we take part 1, part 2 and part 3, these things upon cleavage will give 1, 2 and 3 part. The indication of double bond is also ascertained if we take this part cleavage, aqueous sodium carbonate will give methyl heptanone and acetaldehyde. So we can see the double bond depiction is shown in these two reactions. Now coming over to the synthesis of citral. If we take methyl heptanone, you are using zinc and iodoacetate. This reaction is called Rifaut-Maxey reaction, where zinc OZNI and COO C2H5. This ET means C2H5. And the reaction upon hydrolysis will give rise to acid and OH. Upon dehydration with acetic anhydride gives the geranoic acid. This geranic acid upon heating with calcium acetate will give rise to citral. This is the synthesis of citral. Now we come over to another terpenoid, which is nerol. Nerol and geraniol are two isomers of geraniol. Is cis and this is transform. C10H18O. This is the molecular structure. It is generally found in neroli oil and has rose-like odor. Its boiling point is 225 degrees Celsius. It is a colorless liquid. Acyclic monoterpenoids, which upon oxidation give citral B, and these upon oxidation will give aldehyde group will give acid. This shows the presence of primary alcohol in case of nerol. The presence of two carbon-carbon bond can be ascertained by adding bromine. By adding two molecular bromine, we get tetrabromide. The presence of primary alcohol is also ascertained by oxidation. This alcoholic group upon oxidation give aldehyde group. This upon oxidation will give acid. That is, we have got the same number of carbon atoms. Cyclization of nerol give rise to dilute sulfuric acid, give rise to alpha terpeniol. Now next part is alpha terpeniol, another form of terpenoids. So alpha terpenoid, this is the molecular structure, this is the skeleton part. It is generally found in cardamom oil or camphor oil. Monoterpenoid, although this is monocyclic, melting point is 35 degrees Celsius. The presence of one double bond can be seen by adding a bromine will give dibromo alpha terpenoid. The presence of OH group is given by using acetic acid, which give monoacetyl derivative, and this undergoes hydrogenation easily but not oxidized. Thus, this ascertain the presence of 3 degree alcohol. The nature of carbon skeleton can be seen by using sulfuric acid, where we will get paracyamine. This shows that alpha terpeniol is containing a 6-membered ring. Now we can move over to the next slide and we can see that alpha terpeniol on oxidation give rise to this OH and this OH. Upon chromic acid and acetic acid, there is a cleavage which give rise to keto acid. Upon dehydration, ketolacton, oxidation, this is an again a cleavage which gives acid group. Upon oxidation, another cleavage, that is CO2 is coming out. This is called homoterpenylic acid. Then terpenylic acid, upon oxidation, terebic acid. We will get terebic acid. You can also study the terebic acid synthesis using ethyl acetoacetate. Ethyl acetoacetate helps for the synthesis of terebic acid. You can refer any big books for this. Now we will synthesize alpha terpeniol using para toluic acid. Number 1 is H2SO4, 2KOH and H+. This will give the insertion of OH group in this position. Now sodium and ethanol will remove the bond, and this upon HBr addition will induce the bromine atom in the beta position. Now HBr removal in presence of pyridine will give this structure. There will be insertion of double bond. Now ethanol HCl, two molecules of methyl magnesium iodide and H+ give rise to alpha terpeniol. So we can easily synthesize alpha terpeniol using toluic acid. Thank you.